Look at your neighbor, tell him you can still have the word of God. Remember, his word is a lamp unto my feet. You can still have the word of God, but it not impact your life because you didn't saturate it in the oil. Tell your neighbor, you got to go before the presence of God and get a little more oil from God for your life. And so it's without oil that the flame went out quickly. And I can only imagine those foolish virgins scurrying that point. I can imagine them beginning to say, uh-oh, we don't know what we're going to do because we're out of oil. Look at somebody near you and tell them, I don't know what you're going to do either. See, this is the season where we want to lean on somebody. This is the period when we want to rely on somebody else's oil. Look at your neighbor, tell them you're going to need your own oil. Tell your neighbor, I don't know what's coming for your life, but in this season of preparation, you better get your own oil. I don't know what's going to hit you tomorrow. I don't know what is anticipated for your future, but you've got to wake up and get your own oil. Look at somebody near you and tell them, I need some oil. Because when we talk about the oil, we understand that there were these five foolish virgins who were depending on somebody else to supply them with what they needed for their lamp. But one of the things that we see in the text is that the oil has got to be your own. Lord have mercy. Look at somebody near you, tell them, get your own oil. Yes, you got to have your own oil. Because here is the implication then. Sometimes we intend to shine from the light of somebody else. Look at your neighbor and tell them, you've got to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. And if you're going to shine, it's going to be because you've got oil in your lamp. You're not going to be able to shine off of my oil because I don't have enough oil for your lamp. I only have enough oil for my lamp. And so when we talk about shining with another person's oil, that oil is also symbolic of the presence of the Holy Spirit and what he does through us. And so one of the works of the Holy Spirit in our lives is that he works through us to experience or express compassion to somebody else. Look at somebody near you and tell them, I hear the Lord calling me to let my light so shine before men that they may glorify the Father which is in heaven. Here it is. These women have gone to meet the bridegroom. All 10 of them were on their way. But here is the procession. It gives them the opportunity for admission. But just because you in the procession, just because you are proceeding toward a goal, does not mean that you will be given access when you get there. Look at your neighbor, tell him you can process, but does not mean you're going to be admitted. I remember when I was graduating from high school years ago, and you had to have certain qualifying criteria in order to march. You could not get up in the line without all of your credits. You could show up on that day. You didn't get to say, I'm coming back next semester, and I'm going to finish my last class next semester. Because when you showed up on graduation day and you filled out the card with your name on it, they checked the roll right then and they basically said, go ahead and process. But if your name wasn't on the roll, they pulled you out of the line. Tell your neighbor, you went to school like everybody else. You had a lamp like everybody else, but you didn't bring no oil. Look at somebody near you and tell them, you are going to need some oil for your lamp. The Bible reminds us that all of these women, all 10 of them, were being called to personal preparation. And so that time when the bridegroom had not come, when they started out on their journey to go to meet the bridegroom, that was the time that they were supposed to be preparing. And so while you're working, somebody say, get ready. While you're trying to forgive, you need to forgive. While you're saying the Lord is working on me, I'm trying to show you what preparations are looking like today. While you're trying to deal with somebody, I want you to understand, don't let him catch you with your works undone, because you have no idea what the Lord is calling you to. You have no idea what God is requiring of you.